Hi, all, and welcome. Now, books have been written and films have been made on the subject of mushrooms and Christianity. I was looking at these guys here. We have David. He is slaying Goliath. He's taking the head off Goliath, according to Bill Donahue. We have David here representing the child's mind. That's part of the consciousness within you. It's part of your mind slaying the beast mind. So this is a battle within us, a battle within our heads, so to speak. So we're talking about consciousness here. Now, talking about consciousness, I also saw these mushrooms here in the background, and it reminded me of some photographs I've taken. So we'll just move ahead and we'll have a look at those. So we're going to this part of Sydney here, Croydon. And we're going to have a look at this church. We'll have a look at some crosses that are right here. We'll take a quick note of the house across the road as well. Here's the church. We're just going to go to this part here. That's where the crosses are. So there they are. I saw those and I just looked at who carved this? It just looks like You know what? Just looks like the mushrooms here. So it's pretty self-explanatory. So I find this part interesting. We'll talk about the hole going through this holy cross as well. And there we go. Here's another comparison. We have some mushies here. Pretty self-explanatory. And this is a Greek Orthodox parish in Victoria, and we have this black part behind the cross, which I find interesting as well. It's interesting that the artist put the black in here, so we have this black kind of vortex, perhaps. We'll just keep talking about things here. So, what do we have here? We have, well, we have Jesus on the cross over here. He's on a cross, on a cross. Now we have the light behind him, and we have light here, and we have light to dark. There is various sort of lights to dark there. We have light behind his head up here. We have dark here, dark light. Just interesting things to note, I think. This is in the Asiatic Hotel in Dubai. We're looking straight up into a chandelier. It's got that whiteness around here. And then the black kind of reminds me of this white part here with the black. Here we have the Eye of Ra. So it's just black in the middle here. We just have this black part here. Here is an eye. We have the iris and pupil. Now here is an eye that is perhaps under the influence of a psychogenic substance, and we have the dilated pupil. So we almost have no iris there. So. Let's just keep moving on. This is within the Supreme Court in Wellington. This is the Supreme Court of New Zealand in Wellington. And we have this, was perhaps a sort of an eye-ish looking skylight up here, if you will. Now, in the middle, we have the iris. It's like a bit of a vortex in a way, the structure of the panels up here. Letting through the light, but there's a vortex-like structure to it as well. And we have coming down here what I call the Vesica Pisces fractal coming out of that. Now this picture is from Cirque du Soleil, Iris. This company, their artwork, look, it's just a cult from start to finish. What can I say? Now, in this particular depiction here, we have what is perhaps a portal, and this is perhaps the surface of the sun or a star. Okay, so we have what is perhaps a portal here, and this figure is moving through that portal. On the interior here, the only thing I can see is an E. Well, that's the letter that has the most prominence. Now, as Michael Tsarian says, the E can sometimes be used and prominated because the E stands for the ether. On the head here of this figure, we have this box, which is perhaps a red cube. And we have darkness here and then light, iris. Always interesting, the Cirque du Soleil stuff. We'll move on. We're now looking at the front of the church. We'll have a quick look at the mosaic up here. So here we have, this is Mary here. Now this figure here, we have the black part here, and then we have this brownish part there. So maybe this part in here represents the dilated pupil, and this part represents the iris. Who knows? Who knows? So there's a mosaic there. Anyway, I just thought to point that out. Up here is perhaps, this is perhaps mushroom-like. Sure, it's a bit like other things as well, the usual suspects, but it's mushroom-like as well. So that's what I think anyway. So we'll just have another, there's a close-up of it. So this is the house across the road. Just a quick note, maybe this is the priest lives just across the road. It might be tied in with the church. We have these here, which are perhaps representative of the pineal gland, and we have these lions of Judah here, also representative of a state of consciousness, higher states of consciousness. So if this is the house, perhaps the priest lives here from the church. Perhaps you can go in for some tea and biscuits and maybe some mushrooms. Who knows? So there's another shot. So this is that house there, and that's the pineal gland there, and we're just looking back at the church there. And another shot. This is a separate shot I took in the Greek Orthodox Church in Burwood, Sydney. And we have this red bird here and the blue bird. Perhaps they both represent the both hemispheres of the brain. They both are looking towards this here, which is perhaps representative of the pineal gland. And again, we have Jesus adorned in the red and the blue, perhaps representative of the left and right sides of the brain. Interesting logo here with perhaps what is occultly the pineal gland in the middle. Here we have just a bit of a comparison, really. Look, you know, this is a new structure. What went through the head of the person who designed this, I wonder? You know, and then down in Melbourne, we have outside the church here, we have this fountain that I've likened to this Ptolemaic map of the universe, if you will, of the sort of path of the soul through the universe. But that's in a separate video. That's in the Occult Melbourne Part 6 and Part 5. I start out in Part 5. I start describing that fountain. But you know, these are sort of modern sort of things outside churches, and who sort of goes and designs these things and puts them there? And yet, what do the people who go to these churches and attend and, you know, give money and all the rest of it, what do they know about these things? I'm suggesting that these represent things that the people who go to the churches have no real idea about. So I just thought I'd point these things out. I hope you enjoyed the presentation, the video. Bye for now.